Hello, everyone. I will do it today. To sum up a movie, the film begins with Neil and Simon heading to the University of Wells for a wild party. But when they arrive, they quickly realize that Will, dressed as a Harry Potter character, is planning a big prank. With nowhere to go and no party to attend, things seem hopeless for the three of them. Neil's phone buzzed with an email from her long-lost boyfriend, Jay. Jay, who has been living in Australia, bragged about his new job as a vice president host at a top nightclub and the lavish lifestyle that comes with it. As everyone knows, the excitement has just begun. Frustrated and frustrated, the boys head to a nearby bar. Nia Long wants to experience the adventure and excitement of Australia rather than being stuck in Bristol with Will, and Simon can relate to the stress of his rocky relationship with girlfriend Lucy. Has a tendency to burn clothes for fun and feels the pressure of being ostracized at university. Their boring lives are in stark contrast to Jay's seemingly perfect life in a luxurious Australian villa, and the three make a bold decision: travel to Australia. The trio arrived in Australia and immediately used Google Maps to track Jay down. Neil leads the way to Jay's so-called lavish mansion, only to find himself at the Revolution Bar. When the boys discover that Jay's job is anything but glamorous, it soon becomes clear that Jay is just a toilet attendant at the club, although Jay tries to hide the truth from the boys who see through his lies. And at the club, he meets his preschool crush Katie, who invites him on a trip to Byron Bay. He hesitates, but before he can make a decision, he returns to his life. The friends are back, and they really want to catch up with Jay. However, Jay's shift soon starts, and instead of going back to work, he decides to take charge, let his friends have a great time, and act like he owns the place. The boys arrived at Jay's humble abode, a small tent in his Uncle Brian's front yard, to consider where they would stay for the next month. Simon decides it's time to end things with Lucy, so he ducks into Uncle Brian's house to video call her. Uncle Brian tried to convince Simon to reconsider the breakup, pointing out that Lucy was a rare beauty, and that this might be Simon's only chance for love. But Simon ignored the advice and continued to call. But when he talked to Lucy, Uncle Brian jumps in to ask about marriage, and Lucy is shocked when she mistook this as a question from Simon to Simon. Lucy agrees, forcing Simon to accept a proposal he never actually made. In the meantime, he persuaded others to accompany him on a trip to Byron Bay the next day. The group arrives at the bus stop, where they meet Katie. She was happy for him to come on the trip, but told her he would be traveling with the children. When they set off, they had no idea how to get to Byron Bay and follow the bus. After arriving at their destination, they decided to spend the night in a youth hostel. There, she and a traveling companion named Ben were welcomed. But despite the unwelcome reception, Ben assumed Will and his friends were just here for a holiday, so the greeting was met with a lukewarm response. Will ignored this and moved on later that night. Will and the boys joined the others around the campfire, Katie taking a spot next to Will and the two having a great time together. Simon, on the other hand, suspects that Jay is still attracted to his six-year-old ex-Jane has feelings. This suspicion comes from Simon's discovery of a photo of Jane wearing a Splash Planet t-shirt using Uncle Brian's computer, which Jay often uses while the campfire crackles. He accepted the challenge, played guitar for Katie, and serenaded her with "The First Time I Saw Your Face" in a falsetto voice. Katie was so moved that she leaned forward and kissed Will, who was the source of his happiness. Hard to believe. This romantic moment stands in stark contrast to the drama surrounding Simon and Jay. The next day, Will was waking up and he's ready to take the next step. But when he approaches Katie in the morning, she tells him she doesn't remember anything and tries to recall the kiss to remember. But Katie only could chalk it up to the fact that the alcohol was causing her to act strangely despite some minor setbacks. She's keeping a good mood and knows he can still spend the day with Katie at Splash Planet. Okay, guys, take a break, and remind yourself to comment on the video and subscribe to the channel, and if you like what you see, review it. Splash Planet searches for Katie, while Neil swims with dolphins and Simon and Jay decide to relax by the kiddie pool. When Jay learns that Jane broke up a month ago, he's disappointed to find Jane. Simon, on the other hand, gets into trouble at the kiddie pool when a joke goes wrong, leading to angry parents beating him up and him falling on top of a kid in the pool. Neil has been swimming with dolphins and his meatball sandwich feeding kills one of them, causing him to flee the scene, while Will takes a disastrous turn as he continues to search for what he believes is Katie. He wants to sleep with him, and even though she claims not to remember the kiss the night before on Splash Planet, he'll rush down the water slide with Ben, who wants to take on the challenge. However, things took a disastrous turn when Neil experienced an intestinal inflammation that stained him, and unfortunately, the mess ended with him running down the slide, and when he reached the bottom, he was splashed with everywhere, causing him to move uncontrollably while Katie watched in horror, completely trapped. The unpleasant sight the boys saw made them leave. After experiencing a series of embarrassing events, they were escorted out of the Splash Planet. On the way back to the car, Jay revealed to everyone that he had followed him all the way and traveled to, and they hoped to make amends after Jane expressed her desire to lose weight. With a glimmer of hope, the boys return to the youth hostel to ask Lucy if she knows Jane's whereabouts. Things get heated at the youth hostel when the boys return. Simon takes the matter into his own hands and calls Lucy via Skype to inquire about Jane's whereabouts. Lucy reveals that Jane works on a farm in Birdsville, igniting a spark of hope among the team. However, Will has other plans, arranges to spend time with Katie, and leaves the group for the opportunity. The rest of the crew, but things don't go as planned, and while Will is rocking the boat and becoming the butt of all the jokes that night, he learns that Katie is having fun and has sex with anyone. None have an on-again, off-again relationship except for Ben Weir's main rival on this trip. Uman Ware disowned the group and returned to the dormitory, determined to catch up with the boys. He booked a flight to Birdsville and got on the next plane to accompany her on the journey. The trio of Neil, Simon, and Jay hit a pub on a road trip, but their reunion was cut short. Will suddenly appeared in the rearview mirror. Rushing to his friends, he sets off to find Jane, putting aside previous differences to achieve her goal. Their journey takes a turn for the worse when they run out of gas in the sweltering heat of the Australian outback and see no water. We're talking about being trapped in the worst conditions, trapped in a hot desert with no water. The boys were at their wit's end. Will Neil. Simon and Jay made many attempts to find water, but were unsuccessful as they lay down. We believe their time has come, and we apologize to Jay for not being able to fulfill his dream. The group shared their thoughts and expressed their gratitude to each other before eventually succumbing to the heat. The next thing they woke up was a man laughing at them and throwing water on them. It turns out that they were rescued by Jane and her colleagues as soon as they saw her. Jay immediately gets down on his knees and proposes to her, even though Jay is moved by the effort to find her. Jane declined the suggestion and instead provided everyone with drinking water and had one of her colleagues repair their cars. Her spirits were lifted and her thirst quenched. The group returns, grateful for the unexpected desert adventure. After a long journey, the children finally arrived at Uncle Brian's house. Simon, eager to fill Lucy in on their adventures, calls her and announces that he has had a life-changing experience and is now ready to get married. But Lucy reveals that she is dating one of his friends, Pete, and he much to Simon's shock. Their relationship ended when Will's mother and Jay's father flew to Australia. As he checks on their son, he also receives some unexpected news. His mother tells him that she is dating Phil, his former school teacher, and is currently on vacation with him. The film ends with the boys returning to England after a 7-month trip. Jay grew his hair out in braids, while Neil struck up a relationship with an older traveler staying at a Byron Bay hotel. He is shocked when he discovers that his mother is dating his former schoolteacher Phil and is engaged. This journey changes each of them. You'll get to know them in different ways, but the memories of their wild adventures in Australia will stay with them forever. Thank you for watching, Don't forget, like, comment, subscribe for more videos like this. Turn on the notifications and leave a like to help the channel out. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video.